Dana.
A bright cloud of music, shall we fly?
One, two, three, and.
Shall we dance?
One, two, three, and.
Shall we then say goodnight and meet goodbye?
That's beloved actress Marin Mazzie in her final Broadway show in 2016, singing Shall We Dance from The King and I. The Tony Award nominee was in remission from ovarian cancer when she took on that role, a production she called healing and enjoyable. For nearly 3 years after her 2015 diagnosis, Marin candidly shared what she was going through with her treatments and what she'd learned to raise awareness about ovarian cancer and to encourage early detection. She wanted to put a face on ovarian cancer. Along with her husband, Broadway actor Jason Danieley, she met with congressional members in Washington seeking more funding for ovarian cancer research. Marin's attitude and efforts were as bright and powerful as the Sopranos' remarkable stage performances. Marin Mazzie died at age 57 on September 13, 2018. Jason Danieley, Marin's husband and duet partner on Broadway and many a concert stage, is here with me to talk about her advocacy and his concert in tribute to her on September 22nd, which is also a fundraiser for the nonprofit organization Cancer Support Community. Thank you, Jason, for being here.
Thank you for having me.
You hear it in my voice. I was a big fan, and I got to meet her.
You were a big fan, and she adored you.
Thank you.
You were so gracious to have us on once before when we were doing Next to Normal on Broadway. So thank you for having me back.
You are wearing a ribbon.
Yes, teal ribbon for ovarian cancer awareness, which September is that month, and that is why we chose to have this concert at Feinstein's 54 Below during the month of September to highlight that.
How are you doing?
It depends on the moment, and the moments are mixed too. I'm having an incredible, joyous moment here with you to talk about Marin. So it's to continue her advocacy. So it's buoying mm-hmm. at the same time, hard to watch those photographs and the video clips.
I do understand. you guys became supporters of Cancer Support Community. Tell us about Marin through her journey and why this organization was the right one for her.
Kim Thibodeau, the CEO of CSC, approached us in 2016 to give us an award, actually, and there's no better way to lure an actor than to give to praise them, but it was for it was an award that is now in Marin's name, the Marin Mazzie Award for Empowerment, and we shared it, she for her putting a face, as you said, on ovarian cancer, and for me for writing the blog that I was documenting our journey at the time. And that just got us in there. They give over $50 million annually to free services, as you said, globally to people who are living with cancer and their families, not just ovarian cancer, any cancer at any stage that you're having it.
One of the things that you and Marin, it was so important talking about early detection. She was open talking about her symptoms.
The symptoms are constant urination, constipation, feeling full, quickly, pelvic pain, things that women feel regularly.
Sure.
And it could be a symptom for anything. So you have to know your body because there's no early detection test. You have to jump on it because, unfortunately, when it is diagnosed, it's usually late stage, like Marin's was, stage four.
Her talent, her resilience, the beauty of her voice, sort of connect that person with the person who fought cancer.
I know exactly what you're saying. That's Marin's essence. She's not wasn't a Pollyanna. Mm-hmm. She wasn't like everything's great and happy. She was a realist, if anything. But she did have this power of positive thinking. She called her chemotherapy healing therapy to put a positive word for. Title on it, so it wasn't so negative. Yeah, and she went into it joyously. So when we would perform at 54 Below, she called that her healing therapy as well, because she was not only doing it for herself, she was doing it for the audience.
You continue to do work for CSC, volunteering the marathon.
Did the half marathon this year?
Excuse me, I gave you 26 miles. How about that? Was a half? I don't know what kind of athlete you are.
Yeah, no, I run regularly. And Brian Darcy James, another Broadway actor who has been an advocate for Cancer Support Community, we raised $50,000
nice.
Through the graciousness of the Broadway community. community and fans and friends.
Let's talk about the concert. You touched on it. Who will be there?
Tony Award winners, David Hyde Pierce, Deborah Monk, Karen Ziemba, all three of my fellow co-stars from Curtains.
Okay, yes.
Victor Garber, Susan Stroman will be there to say a few words in memory of Marin. The longest running Phantom in Broadway history, Howard McGillan.
I interviewed him, yes.
He's an incredible talent and one of my vocal idols. So to have him there, and he was a good friend of Marin's as well. So surrounded by dear friends.
Well, thank you, Jason Danieley, for being here with us.
Thank you, Dana.
The concert, September 22nd, a fundraiser for the nonprofit Cancer Support Community. So appreciate your time.
Thank you.
And in tribute to Marin's positive energy and her favorite flower, Jason's calling the benefit show Marin Mazzie's Sunflower Power Hour. It's at Feinstein's, 54 Below, Sunday the 22nd at 6 p.m. For more information, go to our website, cbsnewyork.com. We'll be right back.